refuse to remain at the same level. I say refuse to remain at the same level. David refused to remain at the same level. Hannah prayed in a way that confused the priest. So we need to pray. Hallelujah. Now I want to speak something that we must pray even for our nation of Zimbabwe. We need to fast. I am declaring a fast. Christians must fast in the nation of Zimbabwe. We must fast. Hallelujah. On Thursday, we must fast on Thursday. If you are a child of God, I am calling for a prayer and fasting. Let's fast on a Thursday. I think you know what wants to happen on a Friday. Hallelujah. The 31st of July. So we want to pray as a team and to pray for the grace of the Lord even for that day, the 31st of July. So it's time for us to pray as children of God. Hallelujah. And we need to pray for our prosperity as a nation. We need to pray even for the protection of the nation of Zimbabwe and the grace of the Lord. Hallelujah. So it's very, very important for us to pray for that day, the 31st of July. We need to pray. As long as you are in Zimbabwe, I am speaking what God was putting in my spirit, that we need to fast. The Lord was saying, tell the nation, tell the people that they must fast. The Christians, we must not just sit back, hallelujah, but we must fast. We must pray. Our action is action of prayer. Hallelujah. Let's be in the spirit and praying in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let the will of God prevail in the mighty name of Jesus. And we are praying for the will of God. We are praying for the will of God on that day. We are praying for the grace of God. We are praying for the cloud of heaven to come down in our nation of Zimbabwe. Hallelujah. And we give that day unto the Lord our God in prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak prophetically that we stand in prayer. We stand in prayer. So I'm declaring a fast. Today is Tuesday. So Thursday, all Christians that are watching me who are Zimbabweans, we need to pray for the 31st of July. Let's gather, let's pray in Jesus' name and fast that day. We are not eating, hallelujah, in the spiritual realm, because the grace of the Lord must be upon this nation of Zimbabwe. We want the cloud of God to descend upon the nation of Zimbabwe, and there must be prosperity for his people. God is a God who answers the prayers of his people. And we go on the knees and we pray on Thursday in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. So all the body of Christ, all the people that are children of God, I call for a day of prayer on that Thursday, the 30th of July. Let's pray in the spiritual realm in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So we want to pray right now. I just want some people to join me as we pray even for this day, the 31st of July. If you can speak in tongues right now, even before we fast. So I want you even tomorrow to engage into prayer. Let people gather in different groups and cry and pray in the spiritual realm in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So let's go before God. Let's go before God. There are kings in the spiritual realm, hallelujah, that are there, some which are coming in my visions that will transpire on that day, which I'm not at liberty to say in public. But we want to pray. We want to pray. We want to pray. We want to pray for that day. We are praying for one thing. We are using, hallelujah, Psalms 23. And we are also using Luke chapter 22. Hallelujah. I want to show you the verses that we are using to pray for the day 31 of July. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we are praying according to Luke 22, everyone who is writing. Hallelujah. So I want you to pray according to this verse which I'm now giving you. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. There is a verse that I want to give you, that I want to give you here, which was coming in my spirit as I was praying. And I want every Christian. Yes, verse 42. So we are praying for Zimbabwe. The theme verse for Zimbabwe as we fast on... There are two theme verses that we are using to fast for Zimbabwe. Hallelujah. On Thursday. Now I want you to get these verses that we are praying using. Hallelujah. Verse 42 of Luke 22. That is the top verse, which says, Father, if it is your will, take this cup from Zimbabwe. Take this cup of pain. I was teaching about pain, that we must refuse to be at the same level. So we are praying for Zimbabwe on that day, that if it is your will, take away this cup from Zimbabwe. Nevertheless, not according to your will, but yours be done. Nevertheless, not my will, not our will, but yours be done. Let your will be done in the nation of Zimbabwe. Hallelujah. Then we also use, whereas we will be fasting and praying, the book of Matthew chapter 6. Matthew chapter 6 verse 10. Which says, your kingdom come. Matthew 6:10. Your kingdom come and your will be done in Zimbabwe. On earth, that is on earth as it is in heaven. Let his will be done in our nation as it is in heaven. So we are praying on the 30th of July, fasting with Luke 22 verse 42 and Matthew 6 verse 10. And then we pray Psalms 23. Hallelujah. And if you can add maybe Psalms 91 as well. But there are two verses, Matthew 6 verse 10 and Luke 22 verse 42. So we are praying for Zimbabwe on the 30th. We are fasting 30th of July as children of God, saying, your kingdom come in Zimbabwe. Let your kingdom come. Your will be done in this nation. Not our will, but the will of God. What God is willing to do in our nation. Let it be done on earth, which is in Zimbabwe, as it is in heaven. We want the will of God that is in heaven to happen in our nation. So we are covering and praying for that day, 31 July, in this manner, and praying for it as the body of Christ. God bless you, people of God. Hallelujah, for this prophetic instruction that I have given you as we pray as children of God. Remember, I said the theme verses for our fasting on Thursday for the nation of Zimbabwe and for 31 July, we are praying with Luke 22 verse 42, and we are praying also with Matthew 6 verse 10, and then we can add two chapters, Psalms 23 and Psalms 91. Hallelujah. And we are saying, let your kingdom come in Zimbabwe. Let your will be done in our nation. Let it happen as it is in heaven. As it is in heaven. We don't want the will of people, the will of men, hallelujah, but the will of God. Whatever God has in store for the nation of Zimbabwe on that day, may the will of God happen. So the will of God prevails over the will of any man. So this is what we pray for, and the will of God is the best. Hallelujah. It's the best at any time. So we are praying for that in Jesus' mighty name, and covering our nation in Jesus' mighty name. So as Christians, I want you to speak these verses, and I want you to pray according to these scriptures on Thursday. So we are saying, Father, if it is your will, take away this cup from Zimbabwe. Zimbabwe is a cup of pain, and we are saying, take it away from us. Nevertheless, not my will, or not our will, but yours be done. Let your will be done. That is Luke 22:42. So I want everyone, when you are praying, to say, Father, if it is your will, take away this cup of poverty and pain away from Zimbabwe. Nevertheless, not according to our will, but yours be done. Hallelujah. And then we will pray according to Matthew chapter 6 verse 10. He says, your kingdom come in this nation, in Zimbabwe. Your kingdom rules over all other kingdoms. Hallelujah. And when the kingdom of God comes, there are many improvements. There are changes. There are shakings that happens. So let's pray for the kingdom of God to come. It's the powerful kingdom. It's unshakable. It shakes everything that must be shaken. And let his will be done in this nation. And on earth, which is in Zimbabwe in particular, as it is in heaven. We want what is in heaven to happen in Zimbabwe, in the mighty name of Jesus. God bless you people. I love you so much and thank you for watching. Hope you have heard this prophetic instruction, this prophetic prayer that we are going to do, and prophetic fasting. It came when I was praying today, and the Lord is saying, we can't be quiet. As children of God, we have to speak into the spiritual realm. Hallelujah. And during that day, when we are fasting on Thursday, every Zimbabwean that will be fasting, I want you to speak your desires in the spirit, the things that are in your heart, things that you are desiring for Zimbabwe, things that you are wishing for Zimbabwe. I want you to pronounce and proclaim those things in the spiritual realm. We all have our own desires for our nation. We know what's happening in our nation, which is causing that day to happen. So we want to pray our wishes to God, because God hears our prayers. The Lord was saying, I will be waiting for people. I will be attentive to their prayers on that day, and I will be hearing the prayers of the Zimbabweans. Hallelujah. So before whatever will happen on the 31st of July, the actions that will be happening in the nation, our action on 30th of July is prayer. We get into the prayer and we pray in the spiritual realm, and we speak our desires unto our God. God bless you so much. Hallelujah. Are you joining in, people of God, on Thursday? Are you joining? Hallelujah. Are you agreeing with the prophet concerning what I am saying? If you are in agreement, just type something and say, Papa, I am in agreement. I will be fasting for Zimbabwe on the 30th. It's not a day to eat. All of you that are watching me, it's a day to pray. Let the kingdom come. Let the kingdom come. Let the kingdom come. If you are joining, can I see those who are promising that they are joining, that you are in? Hallelujah. On the 30th. On Thursday, it's a day of prayer. Can I see those that are saying, I'm fasting for that day? You can fast up to 4 p.m. Just drink some water. I want a lot of intercessors to come in. Hallelujah. Some are saying, Sisonke. Hallelujah. Am I in agreement? I'm in. Yes, prophet. I'm seeing many people that are saying they will be in. I'm so excited. Hallelujah. So the direction that I've given you, if you didn't hear it, try to repeat or to replay and rewind this teaching that I was giving. Hallelujah. And also I want you to pray in a mighty way. Now, even if you have got spiritual ears to hear the teaching that I taught you today, it was prophetic. I'm speaking something even to the nation of Zimbabwe in a teaching. Hallelujah. It was a prophetic teaching. Those who have got wisdom, those who have got ears to hear, you have heard what I was trying to say through this teaching concerning the nation of Zimbabwe. Hallelujah. It is also encompassing our nation. So with the teaching that I was just doing, it's a prophetic teaching which I want you to follow. So if you are in on Thursday, can I see you? You want to pray for Zimbabwe on Thursday, the body of Christ. I'm calling for Christians that are in Europe, Christians that are in America, who are Zimbabweans, who are in South Africa, those who are in Zimbabwe, for us to pray for the 31st of July as Christians with the verses that I've given you. Luke 22 verse 42, Luke 22 verse 42, and Matthew 6 verse 10. Then we conclude as we are fasting and praying on Thursday, the 30th of July, with Psalms 23 and Psalms 91. So we will be in serious prayer covering that day in the spirit. And I say, to express whatever you desire for Zimbabwe in the spirit and pray unto the Lord and talk to the Lord and say, let your kingdom come, let your will be done in Zimbabwe as it is in heaven, as it is in heaven, exactly as it is in heaven. What God wants, what he desires, what he's planning for our nation, may it happen as it is in heaven. So we are joining in and we are praying as the Christians. Hallelujah. I hope my bata peteniacho, as I was giving you the information on how we are going to be praying. So thank you so much, people of God. Let me bless all of you. So follow the teaching. Follow the teaching. If you have spiritual ears, follow the teaching. It will give you answers that you want concerning 31 July. Hallelujah. The teaching that I have given you, if you follow it, it is a prophetic direction on its own. It will show you what God is desiring for that day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because we speak in riddles. We speak in riddles. As children of God, hallelujah, we speak through the scriptures. So whatever you heard, yes, I was teaching, is a sign of what God wants. Hallelujah. So we want to pray in the mighty name of Jesus today. So I was teaching today on a title called Refuse to Remain at the Same Level for Too Long. It's time to pray. It's time to go to the next level in our lives. Hallelujah. So I want to pray for you in the name of, I said, refuse to remain at the same level for too long. It's time to go to the next level. It's time to go. So you must pray to develop yourself. You must pray to go to the next level. And I said, you don't overgraze the same pasture because you starve. There will be starvation. So I said, you cannot change history, but you can change your future. So we want to pray. Hallelujah. Let me pray. Thank you. In the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you. I bless your people who were watching, oh Lord, oh Father. They have heard and they are following in the spirit, oh Lord, the wisdom that I have given them, the prophetic direction on how we are praying for our nation on the 31st, as on the 30th, as we fast and pray. In the mighty name of Jesus, I release your anointing as a prophet of God. I release your presence. I release your protection, your blood and your anointing upon all the people that were watching today. May you bless them, O Lord. I pray for power. I pray for fire. Rakabodobobodebede. Mozobobobodebedebeketa. Majekrahadiamangaza. Alebo goze. I pray for all the people that were online today. May you bless them in the mighty name of Jesus. May you multiply them. May you protect in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Now, this last few minutes, I want us to join. Hallelujah. All of us that are online. Hallelujah. And we want to pray and say, we refuse poverty. Hallelujah. We refuse to be at the same level in our lives. It's time for us to go to the next level. It's time for us to go to the next level. Refuse to be at the same level for too long. We want to pray for our lives. We want to pray for our individual lives. We want to pray even for our nation. We want to pray. Let's join hands in spirit wherever we are now. Can we begin to pray? Father, we thank you for this message. I bless your name, Lord. I bless your name, Lord. I pray for all the people that were watching in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray, O Lord, that you take your people to the next level. Yes, you are about to take them to the next level. O Lord, as I was teaching, I'm now praying for them. I'm now blessing them. I release success upon them. I pray for them for covering. I pray for protection. Marakatobobobora, every stagnation that was in their lives, may it go. Every poverty, I rebuke it. In Jesus' name, I rebuke everything. I rebuke everything. I rebuke everything. I rebuke everything. I rebuke every demonic power. I rebuke every demonic force from your life. In the name of Jesus, of stagnation and limitations, may you go to the next level. We refuse poverty. In Jesus' name, we refuse the demon of poverty. We refuse oppression. We refuse any stressful situation that was around our lives. We break all the yokes, all the cords of the devil that were in our lives in Jesus' mighty name. Now we now pray. Now let's pray as we conclude for the 31st, hallelujah, of July. Let's just cover that day in the spirit as children of God. Father, we are now praying for the 31st. Moroko Tumunga. Majeje marakata. Those who can speak in tongues, just begin to speak in tongues wherever you are. Rekete manga. Muzozo gomunganda. We are releasing your covering. Rakete kemunga. Muzozo gomuremenga. Mulenda gariamanga. Murondo momo 31 July. Makasekete. Muranda katutumunga. Mulenda kakakaga 31 July. Makaseketa. Murenda katutukuma. Mulandia mosheke munda. Mare brohodima. Ele brohogobosete. No more poverty. Makita murenda mutsutukuma. Malika rita. Mondeke sisimunga. Molo brohodiaga. Indika tutumungera. Enda murekashia. Alibra hazemega, endege tutumungrata, alebroho gigishia, andaka tutukuma, elebro Jesus, your kingdom come, your will be done, moreka tutumunga, mosegete, let's join hands right now, all over the world and begin to pray, rakato toborebede, mokesekete debokata, we refuse any stressor. We refuse anything, oh Lord, in our lives, any stagnation, any stressful situations, raka, any poverty. We rebuke everything which is not of God. Rapoko seta, mondeke tseke mungara. Ale broho diama, mondeke tiaka. Ele broho dumanga. Eshima gadimanga. Azima gademare. Moje, no to poverty. No more to poverty in the spirit. We rebuke it and we remove it in the spiritual realm. In Jesus' name, we remove it in Zimbabwe. We remove it everywhere. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Zimbabwe, Zimbabwe, be blessed. Zimbabwe, Zimbabwe, be delivered. Zimbabwe, be Zimbabwe, be redeemed. I prophesy unto you. I speak unto you. May your pain go in Jesus' name. I speak unto you. May your cries go away. I speak unto you. May your poverty disappear. Zimbabwe, Zimbabwe, I pray for you. We pray in the name of Jesus right now. Zimbabwe, hear the word of the Lord. Zimbabwe, you dry bones live again. In the mighty name of Jesus, may they be glory. May they be grace. May Zimbabwe become the breadbasket of Africa. We are praying, oh Lord, for your glory. We are praying for your this nation. We are praying for it in Jesus' mighty name. We release covering. I thank you, oh Lord, and I say it's done from today in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, people of God, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I am done. See you again on Friday. Hallelujah. That is if we will be seeing the situation. But I will be coming back, hallelujah, with a prayer. We'll be praying 6:30 to 7:30. I'll be coming to pray with all the people. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, yes, Zimbabwe. So I conclude we are fasting for Zimbabwe on the 30th. Hallelujah. And praying with the scriptures and with the prophetic direction that I have given you. May God bless you. Don't forget the prophetic times. Don't forget the prophetic tiles. I'm done about Zimbabwe. We are done. We are praying on the Thursday, 30th, for the 31st of July. We will be fasting and praying. God bless you, people of God. Those who know about prophetic tiles, don't forget, please jump in and start to seed towards your prophetic tiles in Jesus' name. So all those who have finished are the ones that I'm inviting on Sundays to come and fellowship and minister with us, as we will be broadcasting under the number of maximum 50. So I will be inviting all those that have finished their prophetic tiles to come and collect your books as I pray with you, as I have that service with you. So you come once, when you finish, then you are invited to come again. God bless you so much in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. So we love you so much and we are praying for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Be safe in the spirit in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. And may God cover you. May He protect you in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank God.